In today's video, we will see how we can create top sheet for our Excel files. If you are working on any vast data where you have got multiple tabs, it's really very painful to jump from one tab to another. Suppose you have got an Excel file with 20 or 40 tabs and you have to jump from first tab to 40th tab. It seems impossible. But believe me, this can be done with a single click. And we can get back to our first sheet in a moment. Hi, my name is Vijay and you are watching Office Monk. Let's start the video without any delays. This is an Excel file with 24 tabs. Currently, I am on first tab. If I'll have to go on 24th tab, I'll have to click over here and I'll have to go one by one. Or the other option is, I'll have to right click the mouse over here in the end and I'll get name of all the sheets. So I'll have to go over here by scrolling down. Suppose that I'll select the last sheet and I'll do OK, I'll be diverted to last sheet. But to come to the first one again, I'll have to come over here, I'll have to right click the mouse and I'll have to come over here by scrolling up. Okay, or we have got the other option, I'll come over here. Here I have created an icon or button for each sheet. Suppose we have to go in attendance sheet of December, I'll click over here and we will be diverted to December attendance sheet. To come back to top sheet, I'll click over here and we are on top sheet now. In case I'll have to go in September salary sheet, I'll click over here and we are in September salary sheet. I'll click on top sheet once again and I'll be on first page. Let's start creating a new sheet. I have opened a new file. Over here, I'll take salary sheet and attendance sheet from my example file. This is my attendance sheet and this is my salary sheet. Now we will insert a tab and it will be our top sheet. I'll rename it. We will remove the grid lines. Over here, I'll insert a shape. I'll right click the mouse and I'll edit the text. Attendance sheet. I'll come in home. I'll take this in center and in mid. I'll increase the font size. I'll change the font style. I'll click over here. I'll right click the mouse and I'll be going to format shape. Over here, I'll be going to text options. I'll come in center and I'll select shadow black. So we got a shadow under our text. Now I'll be coming to shape option over here in the center and I'll give a shadow over here also. I'll copy this Control C or Command C. I'll paste it over here. I'll rename it salary sheet. I'll change the color. I'll double click on the shape and I'll be diverted to shape format. From here, I'll change the color. I'll make it green and I'll make this some other color. I'll remove the outlines. Now we will be going to insert once again shape and we will select one shape over here. This will be for creating the buttons or icons. I'll double click over here on the shape and I'll be going to shape options and I'll give it a shadow. I'll type Jan over here. I'll be going to home. I'll take this in center and in middle. I'll change the font style. I'll make it bigger. I'll be going to text option once again and I'll give it a shadow. Now one of our button is created. I'll press Control and I'll drag this. Now I'll press Control and I'll select both and I'll drag it. I'll drag it once again. So we have got total 6 buttons over here. I'll select all by pressing Control and I'll drag it. So we have got total 12 icons or buttons. Now we will rename it. So our renaming part is done. We will select it all by pressing Control and we will drag it over here. So all our buttons are created now. I'll close this. Now we have to insert 24 tabs or 24 sheets and we have to rename it. Now we will rename it Jan Attendance, Feb Attendance, and in this way we will rename till end. Now we will rename tabs for salary sheet also. Our 24 sheets are ready now. We will come in the beginning and we will be going to top sheet. We will click on the first button. Then we will right click the mouse and we will be going to hyperlink or link. Over here we get three options: web page or file, this document and email address. We have to click on this document. Here we get name of all the sheets which we have inserted right now. So all the sheets are over here.
In Jan attendance sheet, I'll select Jan. Okay. I'll click on Feb. Then I'll right click the mouse. I'll be going to hyperlink Feb. And in this way, we will hyperlink all the buttons or icons. So all the icons or buttons got hyperlinked. We can see from here. Now we will hyperlink the button or icons of salary sheet. I'll right click the mouse, hyperlink. I'll be going to Jan, salary sheet, okay. And in the same way, I'll hyperlink all the remaining buttons or icons. All the buttons or icons got interconnected with the sheets, but our sheets are blank now. Now we will be coming to our master sheet and we will insert a button over here also. Insert, shapes, I'll select a shape over here. I'll right click on the shape and I'll be going to format shape. Over here I'll select shadow. Now we will right click the mouse and we will edit the text. And we will rename it as top sheet. We will click on the box, we will be going to home. We will take this in center and in middle. We will change the font style and we will increase the font size. We will change the color and we will do it yellow. We will go in text options and we will give a shadow over here also, black. So this thing is done. We will copy this, Control C or Command C, and we will be going to salary sheet master. We will paste the icon over here. Now we will be coming to our attendance sheet and we will click on the icon. We will right click the mouse and we will hyperlink it. This document and we will select top sheet. Okay. Now we will be going to our salary sheet. We will right click the mouse and we will be going to hyperlink. And we will select top sheet from this document. Okay. Now we will be coming to attendance sheet once again and we will copy this, Control C or Command C, and we will paste this in different tabs of attendance sheet. Jan, I'll paste it over here. Feb, I'll paste it. And we will paste it from Jan to December. So our copy paste of attendance sheet is done. We will be coming in the beginning. We will click on salary sheet. We will select the sheet and we will paste it from Jan to December. So this thing is done. Now we will come to our top sheet and we will click on Jan. So we are in the month of Jan now. We will go to top sheet once again, Feb, and we will change the month from here, Feb. We'll go to top sheet, March, and we will change the month from here. In the same way, we will change all the months. Now we will change the months for salary sheet also. So our clickable sheet is ready now. We will click on November and we are in salary sheet of November. We will go to top sheet, attendance sheet of July, and we are in attendance sheet of July. Top sheet, May, salary sheet, and we are in salary sheet of May. If you want, you can remove the grid lines by going in view, show and remove grid lines. We can do this for all the sheets.
I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then. Bye-bye.